Hello YouTube, this is Aina. Today I'm gonna show you a new project involving my drone. Recently I have been bugged to send telemetry information through the Naza microcontroller. However, it's not open source like the autopilot. So I figured an idea to exploit the GPS signal and then send the information through the unused microphone port of the FPV transmitter. So in my case we have a DJI F450 frame with the Naza M-Lite microcontroller, and I have on board a 5.8 Boscam hobby gain transmitter, and on the receiving end there is just a RCO 805 receiver by Boscam, also paired to a pair of cheap quantum hobby gain goggles. So the way this works is by modifying initially the GPS adapter port, which connects directly to the Naza microcontroller. This is modified to send the signal initially to a Y splitter, so that both the Arduino, which is used to process the information, and the Naza controller can receive GPS information. And then the Arduino encodes the signal and sends it to the transmitter microphone input. So this is used a technique called AFSK, Audio Frequency Shift Keying, and it has quite a low bitrate. However, this is enough for sending vital information such as GPS coordinate, which is what I do in my case. So let's see how it works. First of all, we have the Arduino, which has pretty much the whole work as far as the transmitting is concerned. We are using a library called RTTI, which I have modified to work without an RTTI module. It just works with an Arduino, nothing else. And we are also using the Naza decoder library for decoding the GPS signal. As you can see, we're using just those two libraries. Pin 9 on the Arduino is used for transmitting the telemetry signal, the encoded telemetry signal. And as you can see here, we are just processing the information and then formatting it specifically for the audio transmitter. Okay, so on the receiving end we are using processing. So far I only need to get the GPS coordinates, so this little program reads a file, which I will also explain later, containing GPS coordinates acquired from a special software called Minimodem. Then it presents them on a Google map. So let's show you how it works. We just open a terminal over here and run this command. This command pretty much decodes the audio signal which is transmitted from the Arduino on board on the quadcopter and saves it on a file called location.txt, which then my program here is used to process, as you can see. So let's see that in action. Okay, so as you can see, this is our FPV, these are our cheap FPV goggles. The audio output signal is fed to the computer through the line-in port. And now let's start our mini modem receiver
the software that decodes your TTI data. This is the command that we are using. As you can see, we have already started receiving telemetry data, and then our other processing software reads them and displays them on a Google map. So let's leave that for now here. Now let's open processing. Our computer is connected to the internet via personal hotspot from my phone here. And now we're gonna open our application. This is it. If you downloaded it and you want to use it, you have to insert your own Google app key over here, and you're pretty much ready to go. So let's fire that up. As you can see, this is our current location. We can also change the zoom level with the key numbers here. Zero is the biggest. We will keep it at zero. And now let's fly. Okay, so I'm gonna also have to, first of all, get my drone ready. Okay, so now I'm gonna also wear my goggles. And you will see also at the same time the location of the map changing relative to the drone. Okay. So the FPV match is quite shaky because I have mounted the camera very not good. But I hope that you can understand how the system works. Okay, so let's increase our altitude. The software is currently only sending coordinates, GPS coordinates, however we can adapt to send whatever we want, such as home location, distance from home location, altitude, number of satellites, etc. So let's go to that place right there. And this is especially useful for when you go on a long FPV mission and you cannot understand exactly where you are relative to the Google's image, especially mines that are very poor quality. And the Google map is very useful if you wanna go on a special mission. And it is also extremely useful in the unfortunate case you crash your drone, which hopefully won't happen right now. And now let's land again. All of the software is, I have uploaded all of the software, it is all open source. There are links in the description in case you are interested. And now let's land. Here is our car. Let me remove the goggles so that I can land it. Here is us. Let's and this is pretty much it, guys. We have some more. Okay, so this is it. If you have any questions, there are, please tell me in the comments section below. I'm very happy to answer them. Also, if you have any other ideas for this system, you can propose them in the comments once again. Thank you for your watching, and as always, have a nice day.